law of equi-marginal utility is very important law, which helps a consumer in getting maximum satisfaction with the help of scarce resources. Economics is a science of choice making, decision making to maximize satisfaction with the help of scarce resources. The same law is applicable for production also. The same law of equi-marginal utility is helpful in taking public decisions relating to public finance, exchange, distribution. The same law is called law of substitution. And this is known as a law of maximum satisfaction also. In fact, a consumer does not know couple of things, namely how to spend money, where to spend, and up to what point one should spend money and where to stop. Should he continue spending money or there should be a point to stop? Blindly one cannot continue consumption or production. A consumer must plan his expenditure within the given resources. If there is no planning, a consumer may buy unnecessary goods, whereas he is unable to spend on necessary goods. That will lead to an unbalanced expenditure. Therefore, a planned way of expenditure has to be ensured with the help of law of equi-marginal utility. This law is applicable where more than one commodity are consumed. For example, we may go for three goods at a time. Well, if there are three commodities and we have to spend money on those commodities, then a certain procedure has to be followed so that a consumer gives priority to all those goods which have a higher utility. This law is based on the concept of marginal utility, and it is assumed that marginal utility can be measured. Accordingly, we give numbers to various units on the basis of intensity of want. In other words, where intensity of want is very high, we allot high number as marginal utility. Under this given example, if we are consuming three commodities then we allot numbers on the basis of intensity of want, and we show marginal utility from these three units A, B and C, and here we are taking individual units which may be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now on this basis we find that commodity A is most essential, B is less essential as compared to A, C is less essential as compared to B. Therefore, we have to give priority on the basis of utility. Say for example, if first unit of A is consumed, well, intensity is highest. Therefore, 100 utility is assigned to first unit as per the law of diminishing marginal utility. If second unit is consumed, then intensity of want declines and therefore utility is also decreasing to 90, then 80, 70, 60, 50, 40 and 30, even it may be 0, it may be negative also if a consumer goes beyond point of full satisfaction. 0 is the point of full satisfaction. Similarly, we assign marginal utility to B. B is less essential as compared to A. Therefore, we assign less numbers as marginal utility. And since B is less essential, therefore, we start from say 70, then it declines to 60, 50, 40, 30, 20, 10 and 0. Commodity C is still less essential as compared to A as well as B. Therefore, first unit of C will still give less utility. Supposing we start from 60, then it declines to 50, 40, 30, 20, 10, 0, minus 10. This is how we allot marginal utility to various units. Remember, this allotment should be on the basis of intensity of want. If want is very intensive for a consumer, then allot a higher number, otherwise allot a smaller number as utils or utility. Now this law says that spend money on the basis of utility. Supposing income of a consumer is 17 rupees and price of all these units is 1 rupee each, then according to this law, start spending money and give priority to that commodity which gives highest level of consumption. In other words, first unit of money, or say first rupee out of 17 rupees, you will spend on a commodity. I am marking it on a commodity, first rupee. This bracket shows 1 rupee, or the first rupee you spend on A. Now compare marginal utility. A is still getting highest utility, that is 90. Therefore, second rupee will be spent on 90. Then third rupee again on A. Now question comes that A also gives 70 marginal utility and B also gives 70. The marginal utility is equal at 70. Therefore, question comes, a consumer should take A or B. Now it's a common sense that we have already consumed 3 units of A. Say first rupee you have spent on A, second rupee also you have spent on A, third rupee also you have spent on A, because of the intensity of utility, or in other words, where marginal utility is highest, you spend on that basis. Now it should be clear to you that we will not go for a blind consumption of different commodities. We must weigh, we must see that which commodity gives highest utility. Think of alternatives, then make a choice, select the best alternative, and that selection will be based on highest utility. Now you shift from A to B, because you have already consumed 3 units. Therefore, you can change over from A to B. That means 4 rupees you will spend on B. This changing over from A to B is called substitution. This means that you substitute less utility commodity with high utility commodity. Of course, utility is same here. But we have already consumed 3 units of A. Therefore, common sense says that now you shift to B, because you haven't consumed B so far. But revert back to A. Now after 4 unit of money, you will spend 5th rupee on A. Means keep on changing, means keep on substituting on the basis of intensity, on the basis of highest marginal utility. Earlier to this, consumers used to consume blindly, and maybe that continuously they consumed A only, or they consumed B only, or continuously they consumed C only. That is a wrong method, because that will prevent a consumer to maximize satisfaction. Therefore, ultimate objective of a consumer, ultimate objective of this law, is to explain that with limited resources, how can you maximize your satisfaction. Therefore, after spending 5 rupees, we find that A gives 60, B gives 60, C gives 60. Since we have already consumed A and B, therefore priority should be given to C, and therefore 6th rupee will be spent on C. 7th we come back and substitute B. 8th rupee we spend again on A. And later on we find that marginal utility is 50 for all the three commodities. Therefore, select that commodity where consumption has been less. In other words, 9 rupee we again spend on C, 10 rupee on B, 11th rupee on A. Now it is clear that we are not blindly purchasing these commodities. Rather, we are thinking and going ahead. And we keep on changing goods on the basis of utility. We give priority to highest utility at a time. And since now we are getting 40 units of utility from all the three, therefore a commodity which has been less consumed should be given priority. Therefore 12 rupee will be spent on C, then 13th rupee on B, and 14th rupee on A. Then we revert back to C, and 15th rupee is spent on C, 16th rupee on B, and 17th rupee on C. And just see, there is a coincidence that we have spent all the 17 rupees and marginal utility is equal here, 30, 30 and 30. When marginal utility is equal, that stage is called equi-marginal utility. Therefore, we stop consumption after 30. In other words, where we arrive at equi-marginal utility of 30, at that point we find that all our resources have been spent. 17 rupees have been spent and marginal utility is also equal. Therefore, beyond that point we will not consume. Or in other words, if this process is followed, then a consumer is likely to get maximum satisfaction. This is how this law of equi-marginal utility tells us that with limited resources, satisfaction can be maximized. The same principle can be applied to production. We will see in details later on. However, first aspect is that why one should spend only up to equi-marginal utility. So first we draw a diagram on the basis of this table and we give an equal marginal utility or equi-marginal utility on 30. So we draw three diagrams at a time. For example, this is for A, this is for B, this is for C, and we draw bars for these three commodities. This is for A, this is for B, this is for C. Now first we draw a diagram for A. First unit gives 100. So we join 100 and the first unit. First and 100 we join. Second and 90. Third and 80. Fourth and 70. 6 and 60. Similarly, we draw for other units. Or in other words, we extend it to 50 and 60 unit, 40 and 70 unit, and 30 and 80 unit. Accordingly, we draw for B commodity and then for the C commodity. Now for B we are consuming up to 5 units, so we can keep little bit of space and then we can draw for C. And now need not write utility again and again. The same scale can be used. For B, first unit gives 70. So in front of 70 you draw first unit. Second unit gives 60. So in front of 60 and second unit. Third and 50. Fourth and 40, fifth and 30. Similarly, for C, we have 4 units which we are consuming. So, finish the diagram for C. That is, first unit gives 60. So, 60 and first unit. 50 and second unit. Forty and third unit. 30 and fourth unit. Now just see that at 30 marginal utility is equal. And that is a point to stop the consumption. However, on this diagram we can explain that how we have kept on changing, spending money on different units. Because if you don't show, you will not have a comparison. Therefore, we keep on writing the unit of money which we have spent, say first unit here, second again here, third again here. But fourth we shift to B, fifth we come back to A, sixth we shift to C, 6 rupee on C, seventh we come back to B, this is 7th rupee which we have spent, 8th rupee we spend on A. Ninth rupee we go back to C. It should be clear to you that how we keep on changing, how we keep on substituting one commodity for the other commodity. This is the gist of this law which must be remembered. Therefore, 10th rupee we now spend on B. See, 11th rupee on A. 12 rupee, we go back to C. 13th rupee, we have B. So on B, we write 13th. But 14th rupee, we spend on A. 15th rupee, we spend on C. 16th on B again, and 17th on A. And we stop at equi marginal utility. Now the question comes that why do we stop at equi marginal utility? Why should not we go beyond this line? What happens if we go beyond this line? Therefore, we go on the reverse side and we say that for these three commodities, we draw a common diagram where equi-marginal utility is 30, this is EMU, and we advise consumers not to consume beyond that point. However, if a consumer is bent upon to consume, then in that case we will have to explain him that if you consume beyond that point, then the loss of utility will be greater than the gain of utility. Now just think over that your money income is fixed, that is 17 rupees. You cannot spend beyond 17 rupees. And you have already spent money by purchasing 7 units of A, 5 units of B, 4 units of C. Therefore, total A is 8 and 5, 13 and 4, 17 rupees. You have already spent 17 rupees. And if we draw this diagram for A, we get this line where you are consuming 8 units. B we are drawing from a lower utility point. So at 30, you are getting 5 units. And C, we start from a lower point because it gives lower utility. And where you get 30, then you are consuming 4 units. Now we say that don't consume beyond this point. But if a consumer is adamant, well, we can say that if you want one more unit of B, say 6th unit, then a consumer will have to sacrifice one unit of either A or C. So he will have to revert back to 7 units. If he reverts back, the loss of utility is greater. And the gain by consuming one more unit of B will be less. Therefore, loss of utility is more than the gain of utility, and therefore loss is greater than gain, and we advise a consumer not to consume beyond that point. Now the modern approach says that you stop consumption where marginal utility of A upon price of A is equal to marginal utility of B upon price of B, and marginal utility of C upon price of C. This is modern approach, or it is called law of maximum satisfaction. Now the importance of law. We say that law of substitution extends over almost every field of economic inquiry. That means that this law has a very large application, or this law can be applied to consumption, to production, to exchange and distribution. And most important is the public finance for a finance minister, where we say that a finance minister should keep on changing taxes as per the sacrifice of people and the gain of people. Therefore, this law has large application in these fields of economic science. And in all these areas, one should keep in mind the law of substitution. Keep on substituting till you get maximum satisfaction. Keep on substituting all factors of production like land, labor, capital, organization, and enterprise. If you have multilateral or bilateral trade with other countries, exchange goods where sacrifice is equal to gain, and then substitute those goods for foreign trade. Distribution is remuneration to all factors of production like rent, wages, salary, and profits, and keep on changing, and similarly for the public finance.